Hi everyone, Brett Williams from BretFX here. I wanted to do a quick run through of BretFX Text Message because it is a little bit different as a modular plugin, so I thought I'd show you the ways you can use it and run through all the controls. First thing you'll notice is that when you drag text message on top of your video, is that it pushes up, just like an adjustment layer, everything beneath it. So you have a couple of options here. You can build a couple of text messages, and so they automatically animate the next message up as much as you need. And you could lay these all out, ignoring what's going on with the background until you get it the way you like it. And then you can highlight all of them and press Option G to make a compound clip. And there you go, your background goes back to where it was. And now the messages are animating on right above it. That's a perfectly good option. I'm going to delete that. But my preferred way, if your timeline is simple enough, not a whole bunch of complicated layers and everything, you can put your message beneath the video. And as you see, you can't see your message now. Highlight the video or whatever image and imagery you have in the timeline that you want to be behind the text message. Go over to the inspector. Scroll down here in the compositing blend mode and choose behind. And there you go. Now you're, even though the video is the top layer, and I guess it's might be a little disconcerting that the top layer is now the bottom layer, it doesn't flip all the layers, just this one that says behind will be behind all the other layers. So now your message comes up and it doesn't affect the video layer because the video layer is actually on top of this text message little modular plugin here. So we'll do that and we'll add, so when you add your second message, say the one that's going to be on the right, you still want to add it above this one because it is going to push up the message beneath it. And so on, like I can just, once I have the blue message here, designed to look the way I want and the color picked, then I would probably just option drag it to make a duplicate. So now we have that one, the orange one, and back to the conversation on the left. And in doing this, you're now free to move them around, change the timing. Versus a compound clip, you really want to get the timing right before you drop it in the compound clip, or else you're forever double-clicking into the compound to make adjustments and then coming back out to your main sequence to, see if it looks right or times out right. And, this way you can, very easily access any message at any time. I'm going to delete these second two so we can focus on the first message and the different controls over here in the inspector. So, highlighting the text message, and I go over here in the inspector. The first thing is we have animation. We have three animation styles. First one, the standard two messages here, default to, is slide. The slide, which is what you're seeing here, just slides up from the bottom. And as I showed you, it'll push up the next one. They all push the next one up, just the right amount based on the amount of text you have here. So you can do bounce. And you can also do a fade. So it's going to slide up and then fade on. So the only one you really see it sliding up is the slide effect itself. But if you have another message here, so let's do it on the second one. And you choose, say, fade. It's first going to push up the blue message and then fade on. And the same goes with bounce. It would first push up the first message and then bounce on. So let's delete that orange one. And I'll show you how As you can see, the text here says type your text here and the bubble will expand to fit. That's one of the bigger features. So let's see. We'll make her say, what did it say in the demo? My sister likes you. Do you like, let's make it wrap around her too. And so no matter how many lines you add here, you know, it just expands to fit as needed. And the same goes with the font. If you want to change your font, you can see it's, as you scroll through, it is just changing as you go. And of course you can change the color. I'm gonna leave it white. Of course, you can change the size of the text and the box and the data move out of the way and expand. The data, speaking of up here, this is just kind of a suggestion. See, so maybe they're texting someone who doesn't know who it is, some young boy, I don't know. So this is what it shows up, 5551234. That's what I put in the demo, I think. And you can, of course, change the font to the data, change the size, whatever you might need. As to the bubble itself, you can, of course, change the color. Let's make it a purple for the girls. You can change the roundness. And we can change the tail style from a curl to maybe the top style. Now, this top style works best if you, because if you make the roundness of the bubble too much, it kind of shows its behind the scenes there, how it's working. So the closer you get this to square, then this is going to work better. You can also make a side. Just this little arrow sticking out here. The curl is the default. And then under is a kind of a more modern kind of a look. Curl is more similar to the iPhone. A little bit of roundness there. You can adjust the transparency to all the way to nothing. Completely transparent or solid. And if you don't like where it's popping up here, you can move the position around, the X position, and the Y offset controls if you want it to push the next bubble up or the previous bubble up a little bit more, then you can expand the Y offset. Now that's easiest to see really on the next bubble. So let's throw one of those in here real quick. So if we had another bubble, second bubble coming up, it pushes up just as much as this text here. So let's see. If I had a couple more lines of text, more lines, then see it pushes up as much as it needs to fit this bubble in. But if you wanted to go a little farther, you can change the offset. Have it go. The first one's coming up to there, and then this one pushes up way up to there. You can add a kind of a profile pic, an image, an avatar to your bubble. So let's you just turn on this little checkbox here. Let's and it has a standard drop zone. So I'll go over to my media. And choose, I have a still frame of the girls right here. Click apply clip. So once you've got the picture in your bubble, you can adjust the scale, the pan, and the shape itself is a circle by default, and you can change the roundness of that all the way to making it a square. And if you want to change maybe the size, to make it more match the size of the bubble, or just to make it huge for whatever reason. You can do that. And you can tweak the position of it. So maybe you want it right next to the bubble, on top of the bubble, you know, whichever you may like there. If you happen to have more lines here, so let me add some more lines. It's staying aligned to the bottom of the bubble. That is standard if you're using the curl style. So this little image will change its alignment depending on what style tail you have on the bubble. So if I go to the top style, let's move our shape over a little bit. It aligns with the top of the bubble now. Also, if I use the side, this little arrow stays more toward the top of the bubble, and it aligns the image at the top here. Now, of course, you can always adjust the shape position where you want the shape to be. And what's the other style is curl, aligns it at the bottom, and the under, which is where it comes out down here, aligns it to the bottom. So you've got two lower styles and two upper styles. This doesn't stand out so much, so I'd like to add an outline to everything. If you scroll down to the next section, we've got the outline. You can turn the outline on and control the width. Maybe you just need a tiny little, you know, 2 pixels, 3 pixels to make it stand out. And of course, you can change the color to, you know, let's say yellow. And the outline always stays solid. So if you say wanted to make your background of your bubble transparent and leave the outline, you can now go back up here to the bubble transparency and make it as transparent as you like. We'll leave a little bit of a, just let it show through there a little bit. And let's switch it to the bounce. There you go. I'll go ahead and delete these extra lines. So now we need a response. Say we've designed our purple bubble, and now we need to add a second bubble, the right side text message. Let's give it some text. I don't know. Who is this? Who's your sister? And so most likely we want to make the two look similar, although this one can be a different color than this one, as is usual with a text message program. So on the right bubble, I'm going to give it an image. And let's click the drop zone, go over to our media. I have a bubble above this little guy here. Click that. Let's scale it back, move it over a little bit, and scroll down here and give it an outline, the tail style. Let's see, make that under, and let's scale his shape up and make it more of a square like we did with them. There, now he's pretty much the same as them. And if they were to have a reply, the easiest thing you've got now that you've designed the purple bubble and the orange bubble, and now you need another purple bubble text message, the best thing to do is to hold option, click on it, and drag to make a duplicate roughly where you want it. All right, and this is basically how it works. And as you add more of these, it gets a bit more processor heavy. So you probably want to highlight them all and Control R to render. You notice here they're kind of staggered at the end. So they're going to disappear. So you're probably going to want to drag these out to be the same length, just depending on what you're trying to do in the scene. And this is basically how text message works. It's pretty easy to use. One other thing you might want to do with it is, like in the demo, we had just the occasional text message just all by itself over a scene. I think we had this guy here. With, let's see, it was this preset. And of course, yep, it's pushing it up. So I'm going to go ahead and put this, like we did before, behind, and put the text message underneath. You have a couple options here. So if you want this one bubble to pop up here in this blank area as if it's kind of coming off his computer, you can highlight it here. You can go to the X position, first move it over to the left, and then the Y offset to move it up. And behind the scenes, it is sliding all the way up and then popping on, but you don't see the slide up. So it just pops on. A fade will also work. But if you actually choose the slide animation, you are going to see it slide all the way up. Now, if you didn't want that, you could reset the positions and just use the normal transfer tools, that's Shift T of Final Cut, and move the whole frame up into position. And now if you use the slide, it's going to kind of appear out of nowhere. And so you could really position your text bubble anywhere. It's just you're really going to want to have to compound clip each one so it's not affecting the other text message. Because right now, if I were to add one underneath it, say the other side, or I guess add one above it, as if it's the next message coming up, it's going to push that one up and off the screen. And you may want them just both to hold their ground and just pop up where they are. So the best thing to do, you really wouldn't have to do it on this first one, but on the second one, you'd have to compound it. Now we can shift, we can move it to wherever we want it. And it could also be seen now. This is why I like doing the behind mode, because now we have to step into the compound to make our adjustment because we forgot to put it on slide to match the other one. Switch back. So that's there, and that's there. And that's really about it. I hope this is a good starting point for you on how to use text message in your productions, and have fun. Thanks for watching.